Let's discuss today one of the topic of mechanical engineering, that is mechatronics. First of all, let us see what is mechatronics. Mechatronics is a combination of mechanical and electrical devices. This mechatronics system is widely used nowadays in a industrial automation also. So today's topic in mechatronics is electro-pneumatic circuit. Electro-pneumatic means the combination of electrical and pneumatic. So first of all, discuss what is the difference between pneumatic and hydraulic. Pneumatic is works upon the medium, that is a compressed air, not only air. Compressed air is come from the compressor. Whereas the hydraulic system, we use the hydraulic fluid. Hydraulic fluid may be anything, like it is a liquid or it is a gas. So this is the difference of hydraulic and pneumatic. So in pneumatic system, we use different types of actuators. These actuators may be linear or rotary. In linear, there are two actuators like single acting cylinder and double acting cylinder, whereas in rotary there are AC motor, DC motor, stepper motor, etc. So the first difference of pneumatic and hydraulic is depends upon this medium of working. So as I said, in hydraulic it is used the fluid and in pneumatic we use compressed air. Another difference is, as we use compressor in pneumatic system, the medium or the components that are used in the pneumatic system are lighter than that used in a hydraulic system, because in hydraulic system we use fluid. So to operate the fluid, we use the components weight higher than the pneumatic system. Then another difference is, in pneumatic systems, if leakage occurs, then it will not cause any fire hazard. But in hydraulic system, if leakage occurs, then it will be very fire hazardous. So these are the some difference between pneumatic and hydraulics. This topic is now is regarding the electro-pneumatic circuit. So let's discuss some components of pneumatic as well as electronics. Next slide. So these are the two actuators. As I said, actuators are of two types. One is linear and another is a rotary. In this lecture, we are going to discuss the linear actuators. These are of two types, single acting cylinder and double acting cylinder. As we see, both the cylinders physically looks alike as the same, but internal construction of both the cylinders are different. In single acting cylinder there are only one pole, whereas in double acting cylinder there are two poles. Single acting cylinders are used for a linear motion, that is forward motion of a cylinder as well as a backward motion of a cylinder, as same for a double acting cylinder also. In single acting cylinder, spring is used, so when compressed air passes through this port, this forward stroke will take place, and due to that spring, automatically the piston rod will come to the backward direction. But in double acting cylinder there is no spring, so for that reason there are two ports. One port is for inlet, so that the forward motion of double acting cylinder will occur, and when compressed air will pass through the second port, the backward motion of piston rod will take place. Okay, next is a limit switch. Limit switch is one kind of a sensor that is used for positioning, means the position of the piston rod of single acting as well as a double acting cylinder. So in that limit switch there are different buttons or different types, like push button, lever, roller, plunger, etc. Next is the FRL unit. FRL stands for filter, regulation and lubrication purpose. That FRL looks like this. In that pressure is also present in that FRL unit. Generally when we take the compressor from the compressor, that time that compressed air is very dirty and dusty particles are in there. So when we are using the pneumatic system, we have to use the pure compressed air. So for that reason, we have to filter, regulate and lubricate this compressed air by using this kind of component, that is a FRL unit. The symbol for filter is this, dryer, lubricator, regulator, and the complete symbol of FRL unit is this. This kind of symbols we have to use in circuit diagrams. Next is DCV, that is direction control valve. Direction control valve is used to pass the fluid or compressed air in a particular direction. There are number of direction control valves present over here, starting from the 2x2, 3x2, 4x2, 5x2, 5x3, etc. In that, generally single acting cylinder is used the 3x2 direction control valve, and double acting cylinder is used 5x3 direction control valve. We will discuss direction control valve in detail when we see the electro-pneumatic circuit. Next. So previously we seen the components of pneumatic. Now some components of electrical that we are going to use in the electro-pneumatic circuit.
So first of all, 0 volt and 24 volt supply, then push button, relay ENO, relay NC, ENO and NC. ENO means the normally open circuit and NC is the normally closed. Same way there are the symbol for delay, normally open and delay, normally closed. And last one is the solenoid. Solenoid is the output device so that we can actuate our double acting cylinder or single acting cylinder. So let's now discuss today's topic, that is the electro-pneumatic circuit. So as I said, electro-pneumatic circuit is a combination of electrical and pneumatic. So for that we have to draw pneumatic circuit as well as a electrical circuit. So to define electro-pneumatic circuit, we have to define first the sequence. Suppose my sequence is AB plus delay. AB minus. So what do you mean by that sequence? First of all, alpha gates A and B are notification for the cylinders. Means in that sequence we have two cylinders, that is cylinder A and cylinder B. Then plus and minus is for forward and the backward stroke. When you are saying that AB plus, then the piston rod of cylinder A and cylinder B will move in the forward direction. And when we will say delay AB minus, then the piston rod of cylinder A and cylinder B will move in the backward direction. So in that sequence, the circuit you have to design in such a way that your piston rod of cylinder A and B will move in the forward direction at one time, and by using delay AB minus, your piston rod of cylinder A and cylinder B will move in the backward direction at the same time. So to draw this circuit, first of all we have to draw a pneumatic circuit. So as I discussed, this components or ISO standards for pneumatic and electrical that we have to draw over here. So there are two cylinders, that is A and B. So at the start we have to draw two cylinders. Suppose we are considering double acting cylinder. So this is our cylinder A, which has two ports, which is connected to the limit switch. Limit switch is a mechanical position sensor. The symbol of limit switch is like this. So limit switch will sense the position of the rod of the double acting cylinder. So same way we have to draw cylinder B also. So let us discuss how the pneumatic system or pneumatic circuit of cylinder B occurs. So after drawing the cylinder A and limit switch, we have to draw the direction control valve. For double acting cylinder, to actuate double acting cylinder, we use generally 5x2 direction control valve. So this is a symbol of 5x2 direction control valve.
Solenoid is used to actuate direction control valve. Suppose
Y1 and its name is Y2. Okay, so this is the circuit for the pneumatic system. But to actuate cylinder A, we have to apply some pressure source. So this is a symbol for pressure source and this is a symbol for exhaust port. So we have to connect compressor by this port and it will get exhausted by these two ports. Okay, so same way you have to draw the notification for cylinder B also, because in our sequence there are two cylinders, cylinder A and cylinder B. So same circuit you have to draw for pneumatic for cylinder B also. So name for cylinder A solenoid is Y1 Y2. So these are Y3 and Y4. Same way we have to notify your limit switches also. This is cylinder A, so we have to draw or write the notification as a A0 and here A1 and here B0 and B1. So suppose your cylinder is at A0 position, means the piston rod is at backward position, and when you your piston rod is at a forward direction. Okay, so after that we have to draw an electrical circuit. This one is a pneumatic circuit. Below that you have to draw electrical circuit to complete your electro-pneumatic circuit. So first of all, let us draw two horizontal lines. One is as a 0 volt and another is a 24 volt. These are the symbols that I shown on the PPT. So at the start you have to draw a push button. So by pushing this button your circuit will run. Okay, so to draw the electrical circuit, let us first decide which how many number of relay you have to draw. So relay is a device which is used to on or off the circuit. So we are deciding here AB plus is used K1 relay and delay A2 is for AB minus. So to draw the circuit or to start the circuit, we have to decide the last sequence or last position of your piston rod. So last position of piston rod is AB minus. Minus is denoted as a 0 position. Means AB minus means A0 and B0 and AB plus means A1 and B1. So at the last there is a delay AB minus, so you have to draw the limit switch position as a A0 and B0 over here. So limit switch symbol is this way, that is A0, and below that it is a B0. After that you have to start with the sequence, that is K1. By using K1 you have to draw AB plus. So the symbol of relay is this one, which is a K1. So by using K1 you have to actuate cylinder A and B. Means by using K1, your piston rod of A and piston rod of B will move in a forward direction. So after some space you have to draw relay again, that is another symbol for relay, this way K1. By K1 you have to actuate cylinder A in forward direction. So let's see here Y1 and Y2. Just assume that Y1 and Y2 is like a push button. So if you are pushing Y1, then your piston rod will move forward direction, and if you will push the Y2, then it will move into the backward direction. Okay, so by comparing this, you have to suppose to do the AB plus, means you have to move the piston rod of cylinder A in the forward direction. So for that you have to actuate Y1. So by using K1 you have to actuate solenoid Y1. The solenoid symbol is like this. This is the ISO standard for the each and every components. So by doing Y1, your piston rod of cylinder A will move forward direction. But the sequence is AB in bracket, means with piston rod of cylinder A and B will move at the same time. So for that reason we have to do a parallel arrangement for another cylinder. To move the cylinder position of the cylinder be in the forward direction. So for that reason, we have to actuate this Y3. So Y1 and Y3 should be connected in a parallel. Then only your piston rod of cylinder A and cylinder B will move at the same time. So after cylinder A will hit at that position, so it will hit A1, and when cylinder B will hit at this position, then it will hit to the B1 after forward motion. So we have to define the position of the piston rod over here. So again draw the position of limit switch like this. This is the position A1 and B1. Because your piston rod of cylinder A will hit to the A1 and piston rod of cylinder B will hit to the B1. So that's why it is a A1 and B1. After that, draw the symbol of delay. Because we are using second one is a delay. The symbol of delay that is shown in the PPT is like this. This is a symbol of delay and this is notification is a K2. So same way that we use over here K1, draw the symbol of K2 over here. K2 is like this. These all circuits are in a normally open condition. If it is a normally closed, then it will be connected like this. So the electric signal will pass through this line. So by using K2, you have to do the sequence AB minus. AB minus means what? You have to move your piston rod of cylinder A and cylinder B to the backward direction. So for that reason, suppose you have to move your piston rod of cylinder A to the backward direction, then you have to actuate Y2. And if you want to move your cylinder B rod to the backward direction, then you have to actuate Y4. So you have to actuate Y2 and Y4 at the same time because your sequence is delay in bracket AB minus. So for that reason, you have to draw sequence like this. Draw the solenoid. First solenoid is at the Y2 position and parallel is a Y4. So for that, you can complete your electro-pneumatic circuit. So that the sequence will operate like this. AB plus is your piston rod of A and B will move at the same time in the forward direction. Then delay AB minus means your piston rod of cylinder A and B will move to the backward direction at the same time. So why that delay term is used? Delay term is used to hold the piston at a position at a particular time. Means in certain application is a case like after AB plus you have to hold that piston rod at a particular position for a particular second. So for that reason that second is defined in that delay AB minus. Means the delay K2 you have to define the time period. So particular time period your piston rod will hold at that position and then after that time period piston rod will move to the backward position. Okay. So let's check in the automation, that is the automation in the automation studio software. Automation studio software is easily available on the internet. It is a free version, it is a student version. So you can practice it on your home also. So let's see the automation studio software. This is the automation studio software. In that the circuit is drawn as I showed you on the blackboard. The cylinder A, B, then downward it is a electrical circuit. Okay, so let's see how the cylinder piston rod will move forward and backward direction for the sequence AB plus delay AB minus. So start this green button so that it will actuate. Then you have to press the push button. So you can see by pushing the push button, the piston rod of cylinder A and cylinder B will move at the same time in the forward direction, and after that it will move back in a same direction for AB minus. Okay, so let's see in a slow motion. Slow motion, yellow button is for slow motion. So let's see how your wall position is changing. Okay, so wall position is changed by this to this because this is a 5x2 direction control wall. So forward direction, when the pressure source is at this position and backward position, the pressure source and exhaust source is at the second position. So let's now see, after pushing the start button, the position will change. And this red button is for compressor. Red line is the compressor. When it will hit to the A1 and B1, this A1 and B1 get normally closed. See, this A1 and B1 get normally closed so that the current will pass from this and position will change and piston rod will move to the backward position. So that's how the Ariston control valve is works based on this electro-pneumatic circuit, and the delay AB minus and AB plus operation will occur. Now let's see the actual use of the DC. So delay over here is a K2. So let's pause this first. After pausing this, you can change the delay time. Double clicking on it, we will define the time. Suppose it's a 3 microsecond, if we change to 100. So now let's see the 100, for 100 microsecond, the piston rod will hold at that A1, B1 position, and afterward it will move to the backward position. So after pushing the start button, it will move to the forward direction, it will stop at a particular time, and it will again retract to the backward position. Let's see over here. Again, it will pause for the particular time which I've said, that is 100 microsecond, and it will again back to the backward position. So it is one of the example of the sequence of electro-pneumatic, that is AB plus delay AB minus. So that's how we can define the number of sequences like A plus B plus, A minus B minus, or A plus B plus A minus, and B plus etc. Okay, thank you.